Ok, anch'io. Alright, thank you for joining. Let's have everybody. This video is going to be very brief, maybe between 40 minutes and 1 hour maximum, because the things I want to talk about today, they are straightforward and crucial, and so I have to be very brief so that it should get into the heads of every Southern Cameroonian who is watching at this moment. So thank you once more for coming on live. As you get in, you share my brother Joshua Carr. Thank you for joining. Let's share to all platform, all WhatsApp groups. To all WhatsApp groups that we have Francophones and to all WhatsApp groups that we have Ambazonians. So we keep the faith, we keep the spirit, because that's exactly what we're going to be doing in a couple of days more running. And so we have to keep that particular steam, because that we have a new era in the revolution and we cannot allow that slip off our hands. And so we have been working relentlessly behind the background to ensure that we actually take opportunity of the uprising in Francophone Cameroon or La République du Cameroun. And so it is my singular wish to inform you all that we have every plan on track to ensure that we secure our independence, while we are also supporting our small enemy to get rid of our big and biggest enemy. So, ladies and gentlemen, fellow Southern Cameroonians, thank you once more for joining. And that is the spirit of the Ambazonian people. And we hope to have all of us joining much more. Let's get this video shared extensively to all our compatriots of Southern Cameroons. I intend to be really very brief. So, as you already know, that we will be having Professor Lumumba today at 14900 Swiss Lane in suite 102, of course, that will be in Laurel, Maryland. So let's get everybody on board. Keep sharing, keep sharing. Let's get everybody coming, so that we can, push on and push on and on and on. I'll also today be talking about a controversial video that has come up about Capo Daniel, or if you like to call him Capo Pamela, or Emmanuel Ngong, if you like. He has many names now. And so we have to put all these things straight. So this is going to be a kind of one and all video, where we'll have everybody try to understand the plight of the Southern Cameroon's people. That's exactly what we'll be doing today. So thank you. Keep joining, keep sharing. Let's have everybody on board. And so that is exactly the spirit. So we are going to start in the next 2 minutes, as soon as we have an impressive audience. So we're trying to see how we build this. So let's get everybody on. All right. So keep sharing, keep sharing. Let's invite everybody who will be watching at this time. And a big hello to all of you on Ground Zero. God bless you. And of course, your commitment remains undiluted. We have seen how you have all, surrendered your lives and put your lives on the line because of the Southern Cameroon's independence movement. You know, it has been the talk of the town, and everybody's talking from left, right, from east, north, and south, and center. And of course, I want to thank all of you joining so much. Thank you, Julita Zhang, Kingsley Mbua. Thank you for joining. Of course, Della Della, and everybody who is joining. Joshua Carr, we also thank you for being quite extraordinary. And we have seen a lot of things happening across the Mongo these days, and so we will not relent, because we have an obligation to encourage the other side of our bullet. And of course, we have found the right opportunity. And I have just gotten off phone a couple of Francophone activists, and we have a common agreement on what I think I've proposed to them. And those are the things that we're going to be talking about today. We're also going to be talking about the controversial audio between General Nambere and General Nambere and General Ivo. And so we would, of course, be talking extensively on a lot of these things, because it is for sure some of the aspects that would, of course, assist our revolution to go further. And based on this, I think that we have gone too far to be able to deny ourselves the simple understanding of how crucial this revolution is at this juncture. So we wouldn't want to say that there aren't things that we would deny that, as a matter of fact, they can be a little bit troublesome to us. But we would also want to agree that there are things that we cannot deny, you know, especially the momentum that is building across the Mongo. And as a smart people, we have to ensure that we give maximum support and revolutionary blessings to the people across the Mongo who are beginning to rise up to kick out the criminal leader of the genocidal acts in the whole of West, or in the whole of Central Africa, and the whole of Africa, the whole of the world. I'm talking about the criminal and, of course, dictatorial Porbia, Bim Vondok, who has killed many of our citizens, and today he is also on the line of being sent out of power. So those are some of the things that we will be encouraging today. And we'll also be talking extensively on a vast number of things. And of course, you know, we have to understand that the revolution has taken an absolute new turn. And of course, let me get this. We have a revolutionary connotation, especially after looking at what happened in Ekona, where you saw the map, the Republic map, beside a river. We're going to explain all of those things in this live show, because some people got a little bit confused with that map. But I think we already have a very clear and clean interpretation of the map that you saw. A lot of people might not have understood, and some people would want to interpret it differently. But based on that, we have other interpretations that remain very vital and crucial for the movement. And we are going to work on those bases to ensure that our people are encouraged, and all of this, you know, gets out there in a way that is as important as necessary for us, because there is never a day that we are going to hope that our revolution will be different from other revolutions that have occurred across the world. We just have a unique time, because it's happening at the time when social media is toughest and highest. And so we thank you all, ladies and gentlemen. We will start this show as soon as we have at least 500 people watching. But while we talk the crucial things that concern our revolution, I want to get straight to the point why many others will be joining us, and to say it here clear and loud, that God is actually a very wonderful, wonderful, wonderful creator. And that is why we have now seen very clearly that everybody who wants to destroy this revolution is immediately exposed. And we have seen that in the case of Capo Daniel, and we have seen that in the case of other fake activists who have taken upon themselves to destroy this revolution. And we're going to be saying a lot of things here today, but before I get to the issues that concern Ambazonians particularly, because I want this video to be brief, because it's going to be on YouTube, I want to also announce to those who will be joining our announce now and at the end of the show, that today from 7 p.m. we will be having Professor Lumumba, who will be doing a kind of town hall question and answer to all Ambazonians and to other communities around the United States of America. So prepare your questions. You could ask questions online, and that's going to be on the National Telegraph official page, and we'll talk about 7 p.m. It's 7 p.m. U.S. time, which by then it would be like if you put 5 hours ahead on Ground Zero, it will be midnight on Ground Zero. So at midnight, Ground Zero will be here at 7 p.m. We'll start, but we're sure that it's going to be like 7 p.m., between 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. because you know how it is. People will be putting on a lot of things together. But please, if you are listening, make sure you are there at 7 because that's exactly what's going to be. Now, moving away from announcing that the event is going to be 14900 Switzerland in Suite 102 Laurel, Maryland. That's going to be the address. I hope to see you, Fidelis Ambe, and all other Amazonians who live around the DMV area. By DMV area, we mean DMV is a metro area that has two states and the federal capital, where the two states is Maryland and Virginia, and the federal capital, which is Washington, D.C. As you most have been aware, as I've said several times, Washington, D.C. is not a state. It is simply the federal capital because there is a Washington state, which is not around this area. We also have people who will be coming from Delaware, from Ohio, from Pennsylvania, those who come from New Jersey, from South, North Dakota, and from all areas that are the closest. You can want to come around, take a flight. I think you can still catch up. There are people who have already come from Boston and all of those. So we thank you all who are already here. And one time, particularly Dr. Folefat, who has come from Ohio, who has been the brain behind this whole project. And of course, trying to work to ensure that the big success is recorded. Now, with that said, we will go to other issues. We'll just keep talking while we'll be the audience. We'll go to other very important issues. That is going to be exactly, some of the aspects that are crucial in this revolution. And, you know, in my name as Eric Tator, you know, I have said that I am never going to slow down talking about the criminals who want to destroy the revolution. But before I get to that particular, the crux of that matter, I want to greet all our Francophone brothers and sisters and to tell them that we call them at this juncture brothers and sisters, irrespective of the fact that they have been very evil in times when we had problems and that we're still facing problems at this time. But I want to assure them of our support in kicking out the big and the biggest enemy, in taking out Mr. Paul Biya and his gang of thieves in Yaoundé. And of course, the Ambazonian people support any freedom move irrespective of where it's coming from, so long as it's backed by international law. And I have been speaking with some Francophones today, and I spoke with Patrice Numa, and we discussed a couple of things that I don't want to make public. I also discussed with Modestine, and of course, you know her. She's a very vibrant Francophone activist, and I've discussed with about four more of them. And I have told them, some have been asking what I think they should do. And I have told them very clearly that why they are protesting in Europe, and I know that some Francophones will be following me at this time, and I want Mr. Biya to aware that this is what is going to happen. So if I were him, I would just hand over power. And why I told them, I also told them my plight, that it is clear that as an Ambazonian, I am for independence. I know they are for their Cameroon, but at the time when we have two big enemies, the bigger and the biggest enemies, we have to ensure that we assist the small enemy to take off those two particular enemies. So, and I also made it very clearly that be it Maurice Kamto, Professor Maurice Kamto, who become president or whosoever, they should know that we are already separated, and they should just work towards trying to ensure that the two countries do not destabilize any further. So I've said all of those things, and some of the things that I told them today on phone, some of them that I spoke with them on phone, why they'll be observing ghost towns. They said they'll start on Monday or Tuesday. I don't know how that's going to be very effective. And they said they'll also go to the streets in Douala and elsewhere to protest. But I've also told them categorically of the need to take out the Paul Biya regime. And of course, I made it very clear to them the need for them to arrest all Jews and SJUs and governors and government delegates and mayors, all CPTM elites, because we of the Ambazonia, we also have enemies within the camp, like Emmanuel René Sadi, that's an enemy of Ambazonia that must be punished. We also have the likes of Issa Churuma, So I have specifically advised the Francophones to ensure that all these people, they should locate their villages and begin to make sure that they get out everything that belongs to these people, because these are people that are supporting the regime. These are people that stole the elections and get to Pretoria. These are the people who actually are destroying even the small peace that we are supposed to enjoy as two separate countries. So I've discussed with them. I've told them that while you're going to the street, you must ensure that all the deals that have been put in place, because the whole rigging mechanism started with the deals. That is why they must start by ensuring that no deal, just as we have done, I'm transferring the Ambazonian spirit to the Francophone, that just as we have done in our area to ensure that the deals do not function, they also have to ensure that the deals in the area do not function. And it should be very clear, I made it very clear to them that all DOs, ELECAM officers, all those people, government delegates, divisional delegates, subdivisional delegates, all the CPGM people that Mr. Biya has put in place, they must be taken out. I told them in clear terms that this is a revolution, and they must know that they are cashing the coup from us. We are already a country, we have gone, so they have to take out Paul Biya and give the power to Maurice Kamto, because that is who they voted. And they said, of course, it's a good idea, so I will continuously preach this so that the Francophones should know that the moment is now for them to ensure that they dislodge all the deals put in place by Mr. Biya. Because, as a matter of fact, and as you are already aware, no matter what we do and no matter what happens, if we don't have these our brothers of the other side of the Mongol, we call them brothers now because you know when the British and the French they fought in other parts in Africa when they were having issues over colonies. What happened when they came to Cameroon, where they had issues with the Germans? They actually came as allies and they came together, fought, and sent away the Germans. When they sent away the Germans, they now partitioned Cameroon, where we have now British Southern Cameroons and La République du Cameroun. So we have to fight with them at this time, give them all the support to take away Biya and his regime, and then they know for sure why we are fighting. We have a memorandum of understanding. Ambazonia is gone, and it's gone for good. So that is the preaching, and that is what we're going to be doing, and nobody's going to change that. Now, with that said, let me go to some other very crucial issues. And for people who don't know, we have to remain very focused, because our interest here as Ambazonian is also ensuring that we liberate our country. And part of the liberation starts with the Francophones, who are actually already protesting. Now, with that said, let me come to these other crucial issues. You are aware, Ambazonians, that we are expecting a big guest, and so there are some things that we would not want to be saying. But I want to make a very clear observation about the. You must have listened to this audio from General Ivo and Nambere. Somebody, let me just answer this question from Ambe Fidelis, says that they are not our brothers. Of course, they are not our brothers in the intricate sense because of what they did, but they are our brothers because we find out a common interest where we have to fight. Now, I would prefer, let me say this very clearly, and I want you to quote me anywhere. The issue about life is that you have to look at where there is the principle of higher good. This takes me to this other issue that I want to talk about. And I want us to get it very clearly. Get it very clearly that me, as Eric Tato, I want you all to listen. We are already talking with these Francophone people because you know we are already free. It's going to erupt. Now, let me go to these issues. I listened to a very funny audio where they talked about reconciliation and where they said Nambere. I'm happy that Sikot is here because those are things that Sikot should know what I think about the rubbish that I listen to. And listen very well. I am one man who will not chicken out to anybody who wants to destroy this revolution. You listen to an audio of reconciliation between two generals, Nambere and Ivo. Those are the people who knew had a problem. But they brought in another audio in the main audio talking about reconciliation, where somebody started by insulting the interim government. The person moved by doing what? By insulting, trying to rubbish the idea of county by county, which is not even my issue. The problem is the fact that Nambere is saying that he's working now with his brother Ivo and all of those things. And people like Della Della, they went on their walls and they are posting that Grand Zero has united. I saw they were posting. That's why I asked them that, is that all the trick they have as an arm of La Republic in our revolution? Because the AGC is now a confirmed arm of La Republic after what came out from Capo Daniel. Let me be very clear with all of you. And I want to make my point clean and clear that me, Eric Tato, I don't want to hear or unite or collaborate with anything that has to do with Cho Ayaba and that General Ivo. So if Nambere, Sikor, listen to me very well. If Nambere has chosen to reconcile with General Ivo, that is his business. He should be expelled from Momo County. He should be expelled immediately. We don't need, listen, let me tell you something. I have said it repeatedly. Della Della is in the activism forum. All of them. When I wrote Capo's name, a man went gone. That was 2 months ago. I said, Capo, this is your real name. If you know that you are a man, go and use your real name on social media. All of them, they were there before this video came out. The reason why I did not bring on social media, because I didn't want them to say I'm exposing Capo, because you know they have the way that they say things. That if somebody is using a show name, why do you come to bring his name on social media? Capo, I already investigated Capo long ago, although we didn't have much clue about the things that he lied about what he went to do in Nigeria. Now, let it be clear to all of you Ambazonians watching me at this moment. Okay, Emmanuel says he disagrees with me because he thinks that on Grand Zero, those generals should unite. Let me tell you one thing that you don't know. Let me tell you, if there's one thing that you don't know, you don't unite with people who have shown consistent marks and traits of betrayal. Let me tell you, if you care, if you are one person, you know you and I will talk, and I want you to know that I've never failed my instincts because I do broad-based consultation. We don't need any peace, any collaboration, call me anywhere, my name is Eric Tato, with anybody that has promised to crush fighters, with anybody that has been going camp to camp attacking people, we will never collaborate with them. I want them to know that clean and clear. Let the AGC people know today. AGC is struggling now. You see, Della Della and the rest, before they were saying that Ayaba is the main man, he's the president, all of them will look at Asu and the rest, all those criminals and thieves in the AGC. Today they are moving out that, oh, the leaders are on Grand Zero. Of course, the leaders on Grand Zero, that they will be empowered through the county by county. You posted that county by county is tribalism. So that's why you have gone. You want to say that we are in the United States, or your county, or your town that you live, your mayor, because you have carved out a territorial, some territorial stuff, you say that that place is tribalism. Now, let me be clear to you people. Let me be very clear to you people. You people, after this, you go to my wall on Kemi Ashu's wall, go to Driscoll's wall, I'll send it to Joshua Carr. We'll put a video of the real thing that Capo Daniel went to do in Nigeria, because you people have not seen that video. I usually don't talk too much when I don't have things to talk, but each thing I want to say, I'm sure about what I say. Capo Daniel, who called the UN Declaration Committee, is now busted. He's one of the biggest criminals and thieves that we have in this revolution. If a man pays his flight to go to Nigeria to go and look for a girlfriend that he met on Facebook, and then in doing that, he seizes the opportunity to do something about something that is not there. He works with the other criminal called Success Nkumu. Those are the people that are long blacklisted. Success Nkumu comes to my WhatsApp every time he's writing shit. I don't even read them. He writes them. If you go look at it, you take like 30, 40 messages or what, I don't reply. But when I send mine, he reads, because he knows that what I send to him is bomb. Those are the people. So all this why, and look at how he worked. Success Nkumu appeared on Capo's show just a day or two before the video came out. So Success knew that they were enjoying themselves with girls in Nigeria. Then he came, all the lies that Capo was saying, he could not debunk it, but that's a man who calls himself a pastor. Until now, they have exposed them. Those are, it's good. The issue is that the Facebook is free. Like I wrote before in one of my posts long ago, like two or so years ago, that Facebook is like a bar without a VIP section. So everybody has the right to come and say any nonsense. Success and Capo, they can still have the power to come and talk, but we are happy with that video because it has given them zero credibility. Those of you who used to even think that want to believe them a little bit, they're like even you. You supposed to support Capo. That's a man who came to the activism forum, created the highest problem and went out. Because his aim and mission from the Republic is that he should destroy everything that's Ambazonia. Now, a man leaves Nigeria, lies that he has done thorough investigation when he went for a girlfriend. So Ayaba Cho went to London for oil by oil. Capo went to Nigeria for gay by gay. So all of you people, you are doing that block by block thing everywhere. We are seeing that the block by block is working. Now, you see somebody who went to Nigeria. He came back to China after a failed relationship, a failed marriage that he went to plan. You see a very diabolic man, as his friend was saying. This is what we call the principle of higher good. If a man that you entrust very important secret with decides to come on social media to expose you, your own friend that you people were eating together, it means that he has taken it. Who is this? Let me block this moron, this criminal. They call him, why is Molong? I block you, Molong Eric, so that you come. All these criminals that Capo has AGC has put here. You make noise here when you're not listening. I block you. That's how it's going to be. I don't need you on this platform. When you come, I block you, or you exit yourself, because I don't have time anymore for any romance. So you have been blocked. Why is Molong Eric? Come and comment again. Let me see. If I don't block you, I'll open this other phone and block you. Now, you come up. You come from Nigeria. The first place that the Republic asked you to attack was who? To attack the sector of economy and finance in Ambazonia, where the people used to contribute money. So Capo came and created a story with Success in Kumu that it was Tabayan Brado who has a hand in selling Sisiku. Imagine that story. Imagine, and he knows well that he is lying, because he has gone to Nigeria. He thinks that people will believe him. And I was looking at Capo like that. I came immediately and posted that. Is this guy serious? So I want you poor Ambazonians to take note that we have criminals in the revolution, and God will never allow them to destroy this revolution. That is why I'm doing this live show today, purposely for these people, that they should know that it is over for them. And those are the same people who call the UN Decolonization Committee. You see them on the line. And let me tell you something about So Funcha today that you don't know. If he wants to argue, I've said that I'm enough proof. And So Funcha is the greatest criminal that this revolution has ever had. And So Funcha arrested Ekem Apachi. That is confirmed. I just stayed quiet because there are things that we don't like to talk. And So Funcha, if you don't know, and So Funcha arrested Ekem Apachi and then took 10 million francs and they released Ekema. That is why you saw Ekema. The way you look at Ekema, this is not something I'm telling you, that when I released a list of some Boya council workers, I said they were 300 and something, because I have people give me information from inside, and I'll not be calling people's name. And so, Funcha, I want to be touching all of them one after the other, so that you should listen to people that... Now, and so Funcha collected 10 million and some other benefits to release Ekem Apachi, because Ekem Apachi was actually arrested. Ekem Apachi was arrested. Just that, listen, let me tell people something. Before Inso Funcha came to announce that Ekem Apachi had been arrested, because they already showing proof of Ekem Apachi, the boys who arrested Ekema. He had proof, and we all knew. They told me that Ekema was arrested. I was called and I told them that, send me the video. They refused to send it to me, because I could not have published when I've not seen the video, because I knew that something fishy could happen. Now, in So Funcha, I know they will come and refuse. They will come and say all the lies. Me, every time I don't say things I don't know. Ekema now bribed in So with 10 million. Then in So now preferred that, oh, he can come and accept that it was a mistake of intelligence. Because remember that they had already briefed President Sako about the arrest. And everybody was jubilating because Ekema was in our custody. And So Funcha now finally went and released Ekema Apachi. Now, what will look at, let me tell you something. When I announced that they have arrested the mayor of Kumbu, it was clear. I put the picture out there and I told you that authoritatively, that the mayor of Kumbu has been arrested, because I already know, because I have proof in terms of picture and video. I know that I can say it, and no matter how you come and tell me, if you come and release the mayor after, until I receive those things before I announce it. If I don't have the picture of the mayor and the video, I cannot say it, because these boys are very diabolic. They can allow you to go and publish news, and then you come and mess up yourself, they mess up your credibility. That's where they have not, they have never gotten to catch me, because I'm very careful what I publish. When I published at the house of me, John Fundi, in Baba, was raised, some people came on my page, they say, no, it's a lie, don't look at that, laugh, that you are telling me what I know, what I have had information from the ground, confirm information. And now, because I published that me, John Fundi's house was raised, I heard some people saying that I'm the one who sent the boys to go and do what. I tell you, people, that if I have news, does it mean that I sent people to go there? Those boys are already... If you followed one of my videos here, the last video before last, I warned the boys in Baba that they are not Ambazonians. If you remember very well, that is the wisdom, the blessing that God has given me. I always say things before they happen. I'm not a prophet, but God has put his hand on my head. That I said it very clearly here, that those boys in Baba, I named three areas, if you remember, three places. I named Baba, and I specified that John Fundi's village. I named Obang Three Corners in Upper Bayan beside Bachonta, and they are also named Mututu. It's on the video. That those boys were terrorizing civilians and doing this, we disassociate ourselves with them because they are not Ambazonians. And those guys have been killed, five of them. That is okay. They went and they were doing things, terrorizing the village. We will not mourn them. Now, Nso Foncha would arrest Ekema and take 10 million, and he releases Ekema, and that comes out and says that it was a wrong intelligence. Well, let me tell you something. When somebody is arrested on ground zero, listen to this story. Let me tell you something. When they arrest somebody, they tell the boys will communicate to you, or the family members will communicate with you. When I said that the Joe of Mentum Valley, or the Joe, the man who was based in Benakuma, when I say I've been arrested, I'm not arguing you. I'm not arguing with you. They can release the person after. But when I say that, I will know. So I look at that Ekema stuff. I say, no. Ekema is a very smart man. He's somebody. He's like the man, the late man of Miss Bride who died. Ask people know about the man of Miss Bride. He should stay in his house with 10 million, 20 million. Because thieves attack him every time. He'll give them money and they'll go. That is why when they killed the Miss Bride man, I said it was like a public. Because thieves go to the man's house. They will ask for money. Thieves cannot go and kill the man. Amber cannot go and kill. So those are things that you people should know, that we have criminals that we are working with in this revolution. And people like Dela, who claim to be saying that they are just, all of you people, every Lucas Asu who post all sorts of videos, he hand on tight. Make una go post the video where Capo go Nigeria for go market, go claim, say good for go to an investigation. Now when I'll start respecting, I ask, you people have failed. After this, I will post it. I don't want to post it first. I discuss with Kemi, and I'll send it to Kemi. Driscoll sent it to me. I called Driscoll. I saw on your work. Give it to me, because I don't have time to come and download those things on YouTube. Because this, the war, I said it before, that we are fighting two enemies that are already known. Ayaba is an extension of La Republic, and he has his gun that some people are in there don't even know. That is why I have been making sure. I told you Paul last time that Tapang is already finished. Capo is almost done, and now Capo is finally done. That's, you watch that video, Capo left here, went to Nigeria for his girlfriend the first time, and then lied. And you watch, I was even shocked that Nalowa was looking for me to talk to me. I didn't even know. And today, I just got information that if Nalowa is honest, this is the information that I've just gotten from Germany. That Nalowa, where is the information? I'll pull it up. Nalowa has moved. She has moved from Heidelberg, the town that she was there when I published her story, and she has gone to a new town known as Krefeld in Germany. Let me look at that. I have it here. I have my secret stringers everywhere. Just a minute. I want to call the name of that town so that Nalowa, I know she might be watching me, let her know that there is no joke. I have every information anytime that I want to get. Good. So now Nalowa, of course, she's moved from Heidelberg, and now she's been transferred to a city called Krefeld in Germany. I hope that's the right pronunciation. It's spelled K-R-E-F-E-L-D. So that's where Nalowa is presently located, and she's safe and sound. And I hope that she should come out one of these days and tell us the truth. Nobody should be looking for my number, because my number is on my page, it's on my listing, but sometimes the phone might be shot in the expectation, and they go and, you know, you know, they say they don't get my number. So those are the things that are happening. Another one has moved from Heidelberg. She's now in the Krefeld. And, you know, it's a German name. I might not be able to pronounce it very well, but I hope that I can improve on it in case any German person is watching and is offended that that name was not correctly pronounced. I hope that is it. So Nalowa has gone there. And that, why did Nalowa want to speak? Nalowa wanted to speak because at the time, Milan came and said something. So Kapo came back from Nigeria, and his first target was the finance department of the interim government. Let me accuse Secretary Tabenya. I mean, how can a man just come and create lies about people? You come and create means you are very well. The same lie that Kapo and Tapan went and cooked about my paternity. Trying because they see that this guy has become so powerful. How can Ayabacho, Vivian Imbanu? Yeah, that's the name. That's Krefeld. That's it. Ayabacho, Vivian Imbanu, Bella Franklin, Kadi Sise, Tapan Ivo, Lucas Asu, Kapo Daniel, who again? There were like 10 of them. How can 10 people, that's their best of their best, they come on one live show to come and talk about every tattoo and county by county? Yet I came the next minute and I blew them off because God's hands are on me and the people of Ambazonia. The gang of Ayaba, I want to say today and say it authoritatively that Ayaba and his gang are an original enemy to me before La Republique du Cameroun. That should be clear, clean and clear. If Nambere has gone to join Ivo, he should pack his bags out of Momo. If they say it's tribalism, no problem. That's why Ayaba, when I wrote on his wall that tribalism are days and number, because he knows that he has cooked an audio with Ivo and Nambere. So according to you, Ivo and Nambere is Ambazonia. Can Nambere come to Manu? Can Nambere go to Lebialen? Or can Ivo even step around Meme somewhere around Kumba? Or can they go to Indian, where my wife comes from? I mean, when you see people who are so hypocritical, you see criminals, thieves every day, how come that everybody that Ayaba is working with, that people who are related to La Republic or who are causing a maximum confusion in this revolution, and you posted that we should stay quiet? Grand Zero, God has liberated us. And we have seen it very clearly that we have no business with Ayaba Cho and his camp. And General Ivo, I want to still tell you, and if by extension to Nambere, that Ivo, you are an enemy. Take it from me. You are an enemy so long as you work with that Ayaba. And let me say it very clearly. There are even rumors in the village in Baba that those boys are affiliated to the ADF. But I don't want to say it. I don't want to say it and I don't want to believe it, because it'll be like it's because Eric Tato is saying this because he wants to sabotage Ayaba. So take it that I didn't say that. But let me be clear with you that there is nothing that Ayaba, Kapo has already finished, and finally, all the activists, this other one, some people came here and they said that you are calling women prostitutes and all of those things. Let me tell you something. I still say it that when I want to say something about man or woman, the women that you say that they are insulting them, go and read their comments on Facebook. All the Abu Free, when you call their name, they'll carry their, because they, you see those people have horns like the devil, but it's still inside them. It still grow. All the Abu Free and the Vivian Bangui that is, they are turning left right here in Maryland, other places. Go and read their comments on Facebook. See how they insult people. You are last, you are this. So you insult a man. What is the difference between a man and a woman? So you come and climb because you think that it's a man or it's a woman and stuff. So they should not be insulted. Let me tell you something. This page is a revolutionary page. And when I'm talking on National Telegraph, I talk differently. I want to say it very clearly that all those people that they have put there, that I have thought that he put, Tapan is finished, because Tapan is, we have to take Tapan to court because he has stolen our money enough, and he thinks that Chodong Gumba, where Chodong Gumba will stop, will continue. Kapo, as our Secretary Tabenyang, I will have to, somebody send that, stop calling him. Do you know that I can block you from making that noise? Do you know that in communication, the event and the event maker are inseparable linked? So how can you talk about Cameroon and the crisis if you don't call Paul Bia, if you don't call Boya? You do know what is the definition of a noun? So please, don't disturb me. If you disturb me, I'll block you. So with that said, let me be very clear that we have people that have been put, implanted in this revolution to destroy the revolution. Ask yourself that even though Dr. Kwanga is the way he is sometimes, why is it that they are not calling Dr. Kwanga's name too much? And let me just inform people that I want to congratulate Dr. Kwanga. This is the opportunity to congratulate Dr. Kwanga for a wonderful thing that he has done. He has made a great move in one African country. I don't want to name the country until he has come back to base and he's safe. before I can call the name of the country. But you see very soon, he met a very former influential president in one of the African countries that you are going to see soon. It's going to be on social media. I received that information. That is the picture. I have the picture, everything here with me, more than 4 or 5 days ago that they sent to me. I think 4 days ago, if I'm not mistaken, they sent to me from that country. I've received it and I've kept it. I just want to seize the opportunity to thank Dr. Kwanga for the wonderful work that he has done, and to tell him that I'm following him and advised him. Even the other day, when military soldiers were going to Mato, they stopped at Kumba. They were going to attack fighters in Mato, the few Sokade fighters in Mato. I called Dr. Kwanga late in the night. It was like midnight here in the USA. I did not sleep. I called Dr. Kwanga. I did not pick. I sent him a text and he replied me, and we're following up the issue until we ensure that the boys were safe in Mato. That is my job. And it's not people who come here, their own work is to ensure that they don't do nothing. They only come, Kapo here, interim government this, interim government that. Kapo can be on. He can go live 2 billion times. But the truth is that he's a criminal. He's a thief in the revolution. He's a usurper. Now an investigator has been come and investigated. So let us be clear about our rules that we play in this revolution. We have all seen them. And that is why there are same people that Abacho is backing. There are same people that Bo Herbert, an old man, who is supposed to sit down, calm himself. Now, Bo Herbert, I'm authorizing you to write, name yourself a Nyamfuka of the year, because you are the most, you are the highest Nyamfuka, because you have been collaborating with people who are thieves and criminals in the revolution. So I urge you to write yourself the Nyamfuka of the year, because that is exactly what it's going to be. Now, let us be clear. For those of you who don't know, the truth is that we have already known people who are destroyed. Either they can go offline, they'll come and watch later. So we already know people who are destroying this revolution, and we have seen them. And exactly, okay, let me block this person talking about 1K. You think that my premium is view? You don't know that I've changed this account. Let me block you, so that let me bring you on camera first, see if you come. So that after you don't come, I block you. Okay, he's running away. Let me block you. I don't need 1K to talk, Davido Amber. Yesterday I was supposed to block you. I didn't block you. So you are blocked. So don't worry. So exactly what I was trying to say before, you have some of these AGC people. So I'm going to be blocking them because we don't need them to come and try to distract us. And let it be clear that no matter what will happen, I know that the AGC, somebody told me that the AGC is trying to tap my line. They are manipulating my Facebook account and they're doing all sorts of things. I don't know what they're doing, but whatever they do, I am here to speak the truth, and the message is still going to go to the people. Like we always say, that our interest is not to, we don't care about how many people watch us at once, but we have the following, and people who are busy will always come back to watch. So like I said, that the issue is clear, and no matter what will happen, we have already known the thieves in this revolution, and we're asking Kapo Daniel to go you and meet your Republic wife elsewhere. Those are people who took their phones. They took their phone, they called the United Nations to destroy our revolution. Today, they will be trying, you saw how the people of the UK went to the Commonwealth. Secretly, they told only me that they were going to Commonwealth many days before they went. And I thank them for that confidence, and to tell the Ambazonian people that so long as you put your trust in me, you confide in me, you tell me that this thing is not for the public, it will never go in the public. That's why I'm talking about Dr. Kwanga, that I've seen all the pictures. I've received the picture of what he has done, the person that he met, and the delegation that he took to meet the person. I have all the pictures. I'm not going to post it until I'm authorized, because that is how we have learned from the dubious La Republic agent called Kapo Daniel, who destroyed our chance with the decolonization committee. Today, the interim government will be receiving, or the Pope Ambassador will be receiving Professor Lumumba at 14900 Switzerland, suit 102 in MD. In Maryland, that's in Lauren. Now, what has happened? Another fake profile from the AGC called Panambis. I want to let them know. Panambis went and said that the interim government is running behind Professor Lumumba, that a common lawyer in Kenya will give us independence. And then I laugh. Why? Because that is the only thing that I have Acho and the rest that I've written and given him to write, to make sure that he tried to make it look, to try to flatten the initiative of the interim government. And let me tell you that Professor Lumumba is the highest. You will never, in your life, you will never see him. You will never touch him. You will never see Professor Lumumba, because people like you don't exist. You see the Panambis, the Erasmus, in Niba. who is his father's name is Paniba. That's going by the fake profile called Sheep Broker on Facebook. That's a church rat that the parents don't even have where to stay. Instead of you to consider to see how they would liberate Ambazonia, you are there, you are making posts left and right on Facebook, $500 for your pocket. You go where you see some man, you see how broke people for the day. When they write about you, go take one suit, wear them, keep a monkey suit for inside wardrobe, can't well and snap, put them because every time they don't talk about you, one show, say be some person. They will have people go and arrange Professor Lumumba will come to talk. You know, it's Professor Lumumba. That's somebody that the American government brings here. He talks. He was talking in Howard University. You know Howard University in Washington, D.C.? That's where he was talking, and the best minds in America, they said they were listening to him. Then you come and say that it's easy. You think that it's easy to bring Professor Lumumba? You go and write that. Who is that? So Professor Lumumba is nobody. Before, when your criminal master, Ayabacho, the oil dealer, the palm oil dealer, came to Washington, D.C., he was looking for Pam Molanjo to snap with him. I have pictures of Pam Molanjo that I took later, we have discussed. But Ayabacho, Uyupo took Pam Molanjo and Ayabacho, made it headline. So Molanjo too will give us independence. No, let us be serious. So you see, when you try to say things, you forget the things that you have done. Ayabacho was there with Pam Molanjo because that is a figure. He snapped with him and Uyupo put it all over. That Pam Molanjo is telling guys, you go and liberate Ambazonia. So you know that somebody can tell somebody something. But when it comes to the interim government, you want to make a mountain out of an anthill. Let me tell you all these criminals and thieves from the AGC. Let it be straight to you people. I want to be clear to you for that. So long as I stay in this, who is this Missy Bambi? Let me also block you if you are talking about divide. If you don't know what the meaning of divide, I'll just leave you for now. Let me see your other comments because that's what I'm going to be doing today. So we want to be clear about these people that there is no divide in Ambazonia. We already have an enemy. And the enemy is Ayaba and his gang. And that's why he has put all these fake profiles, paying the money to be destroying the revolution. So we have to be clear with them that I don't have any friends with these people. As I've told them, and that's how it is. That's what I've told my brother Mark, that you have to hit hard on these people. It is clear who we are working with and who we are working against. Because Ayabacho came to DC. He was looking only for Molanjo. He took a picture of Molanjo. Probably it was his first time meeting Pam Molanjo. So he took a picture. Immediately what happened? He gave it to all these surrogates, these criminals, these groupies, all of them. They were posting on Facebook and making this thing. Me, that I made a statement that this is war. All I have a show people, now you have to be paying me rights of using my statement that this is war. It's war, not a romance. You took my statement, you are putting it on I have a chose a placard. God punish you now. The same way how Paul Biya went to Gabon and stole Omar Bongo's or whoever force of experience. That's how you put are. All you do is to steal ideas. And then you come and amplify it. Who was the first ambassador to make the statement, this is war? It's Eric Tato. Let me take that credit. And you people go to your walls, you go and put your ambassador that this is war. Because he copied from me. He came and spoke in Washington, D.C. You people think that he let me tell you something. I think I have to block you now finally. This machine. The enemy is Ayabacho plus La Republic. You are blocked. So we are clear on the strategic move of this revolution. That we have people, see Capo. Came and was destroying people's names, making sure that everybody was confused about Tshisekedi. Finally, we could not get anything because he came and distorted the report. The real facts were hidden. Naloa wanted to talk. Capo destroyed it because they want to keep us in the same spot, talking about Tshisekedi. Now, time has reached that we are supposed to concentrate. They have come again about Naloa. Naloa should just shut up because she did not say anything in that video or whatever that she said. There is there that I have said that. Me, Eric Tato. After that, she should just stay her quiet. If she wants to talk, let her talk. I'm ready to take her. Let her talk everything that she knows. Now, though I want to talk, tell us what happened in the meeting, how they were adopted, who came in, how many people, why did they release you, and why did they take Tshisekedi to Cameroon? When did they take Tshisekedi to Cameroon? Those are the things that you're supposed to come and talk now that you're free. You're in Germany. Don't come and be telling us that this man did this. Who tell you that we want to hear all those stories, those romance, and all those small, small side talk? We are talking about hard facts. When did they take Tshisekedi to Cameroon? Those are the things I want to hear. So, as far as I'm concerned, I don't want to get into all these nitty-gritties. So, you have a gang of criminals who have zero reputation in this revolution. Take, for example, Success Nkrumah is the same Success Nkrumah that the AGC, through Akosin Polenziale, accused that he has stolen money and is running. Akosin Nkrumah, today, the same Success that the AGC accused, they are best friends with the AGC. You see thieves. Also, I've told the Akosins that you have to be drawing a line because your respect will be going down. So these are the things that we must preach and for our people to know. There is no way in this revolution ever that will tolerate all these criminals from the AGC. All of them. You see that Now that I am dealing with them, all their fake profiles have disappeared from this platform. So that's how we continue to delete them and make sure that they go away. They will still go and watch after we have posted, and we'll have the same number of views, ton and thousand of views that we have always had in our live shows. We don't care who's watching live at the same time, but what we know is the fact that the AGC is a criminal organization, it's a gang of thieves in this revolution. And so long as I live as a dictator, Ayaba is not a revolutionary leader. He's somebody who has ensured that this revolution, listen, people coming from Gang Zero, many people, from every big people who are sponsoring the movement from everywhere that we don't want to call their names, and they ask me every time that, who is this Ayaba working for, Eric Tato? Because you are the only person that can tell us. You push to take this man out of this revolution. But he has taken himself. He has taken himself. That's Kapo Daniel, a man who knows how to lie. I'm just going to do this briefly because I have a lot of things that I'm doing today. Tomorrow, I might still come live tomorrow, Sunday, my midday, to still continue this issue. After this, we are going to post the video of Kapo Daniel on our walls. Kemi Asho, you're going to post it. Dresco, repost. Joshua Kai, Yannick Sikot, all of you, so that Ambazonian people should know who we are dealing with. There are hard facts that Kapo is even unable to refuse. So, whatever you do as Ambazonians, know that we are united as a people under our various counties, paying our allegiance to the interim government left behind by Sisoko Yoktabeji laws. And that apart from La République du Cameroun and Paul Biya and his gang, we have a particularly, the first enemy is Ayaba Cho and his gang. The second enemy is Paul Biya. The third enemy is the people that surround Paul Biya. And then we have a small enemy, which is our Francophone brother, that we have to make an alliance with them now for them to make sure that they take all the other enemies. So you have seen very clearly. You have seen how Ayaba Cho is there to destroy the revolution and nobody's saying anything. Kapo Daniel comes and manipulate people. You people are there, everybody just staying quiet. People, you will see them, they're going to say, hey, every tattoo is doing divide, because they know that the only thing that they can use to stop you from telling them the nasty truth is by saying that you are trying to cause divide. I'm telling people that, Eli, you go and call my name in 200 audios. There's this other man in, in Boston. I cannot even mention his name because he's not even worth, his name is not even supposed to be on this show. Because what I want to do to him is that, I want to just mention him, let him know that I have kept his audio, Alex Mbianga. I've kept the audio that he did with the other woman that they call, I'm not going to insult them because I want to sue them. I'm going to take that audio, go to their state, and then bring them. You come and tell me what they are saying in that audio, and I'll bring them to court. So that way, because the other people that I tell them back, insult them back, the people who have also insulted us or insulted me, so I'm doing a right to reply. So for them, I'm not going to insult them. I'm going to, because this live show is going to be a witness. I'm going to take it there. I'm going to teach Alex Mbianga a very bitter lesson for calling my name in his useless audios. He's going to become swinging for defamation. He's going to tell me with proofs all those things he has been saying. As for Ayaba and the rest, I hold myself the right to reply, because all his criminals and his thieves, gang of activists, have been calling my name. I have all the chats talking on Facebook and all of those. So we are in a revolution, and we must uproot the bad seeds and make sure that we wipe them completely off our revolution. And now, this very important thing. This other lady, I sent her a voicemail, a voice clip, Caroline Fro. I have 5 more minutes to go. I sent Caroline Fro a voice clip, and I warned her particularly, let her be sure that she stays out of the Ambazonian issue. So those of you who are friends with her, ensure that you advise her and tell her that this Ambazonian thing, she should remove herself from the politics that she's trying to play. So my role, to further notice why at the same time I'm preaching strategies, I'm talking to the fighters on the ground, my role is also to ensure that all the criminals and the thieves from within and without the AGC will be uprooted from our struggle. So with that said, thank you. Tomorrow, we're going to be live again, but today, don't forget, from 7 p.m. or probably from 7:38, we are going to be live on the National Clearer official page with Dr. Professor Lumumba. So if you are not following that page, you go there, you click on follow and like to be able to get the show live, because that's the only way you're going to follow. All those of you on Gang Zero, you're going to stay tuned until that time. But tomorrow will be together once more. Thank you so much. God bless you, and keep the faith, keep the struggle alive, and know that your enemies have been defined. This is the platform of the truth. This is where we call out everybody and we tell them exactly who they are. For now, I'm going to leave you because we have a lot of things running around to make sure that this event with Professor Lumumba is a success. God bless you. Thank you for watching and keep sharing to all the groups and let the facts be known. After this, we are going to put out the video on Capo Daniel, Capo Pamela on our walls. Kemi Asho will put it, I'll put it, everybody's going to put it. Let Ambazonian watch and be sure of who they are dealing with. The struggle is always there, and we'll ensure that we root out all the thieves in this revolution. Bye-bye for now. God bless you.